Welcome back to E3 Rehab. I'm Dr. Tony Camella. Now, as a physical therapist, one of the most common questions I get asked is how many sets of this exercise should I be doing? Is it 3 sets or 4 sets? Is this something I do every day or every other day? How many sets should I do to maximize my results? Now, there are a lot of factors that go into programming, and sets or volume is just one of those factors. So in today's video, I want to briefly touch on the topic of training volume, but also help you better answer that question. How many sets should you be doing? What we know is that changes in volume will influence muscle growth, and muscle growth is important if you're looking to make changes in aesthetics or physique, build overall tissue capacity and tolerance to activities, or even reduce risk of injuries. Now, I'll be honest, it's not the sexiest of topics, but it plays a very crucial component in both training and rehabilitation. In a 2017 study by Schoenfield et al., they found that volume and muscle growth have what we call a dose-response relationship. Essentially, this means that the more volume you do, generally the more muscle growth there is. But at one point, this will eventually taper off, leaving us with this inverted U relationship. The optimal level of volume for muscle growth has been shown to be somewhere between 10 to 20 working sets per muscle group per week, but this number has not clearly been defined. So should everyone be performing a similar amount of volume? Or should individuals be catering the number of sets based off of individual needs? The most recent edition of Mass did a review on a 2020 study by Scarpelli et al. Titled, Muscle Hypertrophy Response is Affected by Previous Resistance Training Volume in Trained Individuals. They took 16 subjects with 5 years of training history. Each subject performed 2 exercises, a single leg knee extension and a single leg leg press exercise. They did this 2 times a week for 8 weeks, completing 8 to 12 reps to failure with 2 minutes of rest between each set. However, the number of sets or volume differed on each leg. One leg completed a standardized volume of 22 total sets each week, while the other leg completed sets based on the individual's training history. Volume increased 20% above a subject's baseline based on their previous 2 weeks of training. So for example, if a subject had been completing 5 total sets of quad exercises over the last 2 weeks, the standardized leg now completed 22 total sets in that week, and then the individualized leg only completed 6 total sets. After 8 weeks of training, both groups demonstrated an increase in quad cross-sectional area, meaning their muscles grew. This is not a huge surprise since both groups participated in a strength training program. However, there was a difference found between the groups. The standardized leg, or 22 sets per week, saw an average of about 6% increase in growth, while the individualized group saw almost a 10% increase. So the results of this study is actually really interesting because it shows us that adjusting the number of sets or the amount of volume for an individual based off of their training history can actually lead to more muscle growth and more hypertrophy than simply allocating a set volume for everyone. So again, the question becomes, how many sets should you perform? Well, the answer, it depends. If you're someone looking to build muscle but do not have any prior gym or lifting experience, start off with lower volume and build up over time. This might only be 8 to 9 working sets per muscle group per week, and it might even be helpful to spread this out over 2 to 3 days a week. In contrast, if you're someone with a longer history of training, have been performing the same relative volume for several months, and you feel like you have plateaued, increasing volume has shown to be one area that can help with progress. Now in rehab, muscle hypertrophy may not be the number one goal, but it does play a role in building tissue capacity, increasing someone's tolerance to activities, and even reducing risk of injuries. Now, there is a huge takeaway here for both clinicians and coaches. We need to understand someone's training history when we're building out rehab or training programs. We can't just simply apply this 3 sets of 10 repetitions for everyone. This might be too little volume or far too much volume than someone's used to. So we need to cater to the individual. Now, I know this doesn't provide you a definitive answer, but there are a couple big takeaways. Generally, if you do too much too soon, you might find yourself dealing with some aches and pain. And for others, if you aren't overtraining and you're able to recover well, appropriately increasing volume is just one way that you can build muscle. The other factors to consider are load, rest, and frequency, but keep it simple. Just change one of these variables at a time. Now, if you want to learn more about this topic or other topics related to training and nutrition, be sure to check out our link below for more information on MASS. They release a new research review each month and do an in-depth comprehensive breakdown of different research articles. While we are an affiliate, we do use MASS personally and find it a great resource for staying up to date with the research. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, just leave them below in the comments. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We will see you guys next time. Peace.